Hey, good morning, YouTube. Are you ready for a new adventure today? Well, today we are going to the CottonBelt bike trails, bike hiking, walking, you name it. It's a series of trails that starts in, well, the starting point could be subjective because it's just a straight path, not a loop, but it starts in, or ends in Grapevine, Texas, near the train depot, where you have the tarantula train. That's basically a train that goes to downtown Fort Worth. And it goes all the way down south along the train tracks through North Richland Hills and several other cities. And then it eventually ends out. I believe it's on the All Trails app, which is a great app if you're looking for biking, hiking, walking, any type of trails for just getting in the outdoors. I recommend using that app. It's just because it's free. And so feel free to check it out. But anyways, I'll be going down the trail. This is really a test of battery endurance on the Espin Sport e-bike. I'm going to see, basically it's rated from 30 to 50 miles. So with this trail being 13 officially, I believe I'm going to be starting maybe a mile or two further down the road right near the train depot. I think it has it ending prior to that, but I'm going to start at the depot where there's paved sidewalks and just follow the trail all the way down basically until I feel like the battery is about half empty, and then I'll work my way backwards back to the vehicle. So yes, we're on our way out there today. I'm looking forward to this fun biking excursion adventure along the train track. So this will be a fun day, and I'm glad to have you aboard. So I hope you enjoy today's video. Thanks for tuning in today. Hey, look at that. It's me looking at me, looking at me. Hey, what's going on? I'll be traveling northward towards Grapevine, Texas for about maybe 7 to 8 miles on a trail that rides along the train tracks. I'll put a link to the name in the description of this video. Now this is a very busy area, as you can hear. You can hear the roadway, one of the freeways, 820, is right here to my right. And to the left down the way is the trailhead, and that's where I'll begin. And hopefully, just depending on how much energy I have physically and battery-wise and everything, we'll see how far we can get along. But thanks for tuning in again, and let's begin this thing. Enjoy the journey. It looks to be pretty empty from the beginning here. As you can see from behind me, that's where the trail ends, right there. And then it goes that way. And if I pan around, that's the way it heads back, all the way up to Grapevine. So let's hit it. Here comes our first train. Check it out. That guy was cooking, wasn't he? He was flying. Trinity Metro, Texrail, Smithfield. We have officially made it to the first stop. Let's check it out. So it looks like if you want to hop on the train, you would come over here and, I guess, buy your ticket. This is, looks like they have a pass system, using a card of some sort, or even using your smartphone. It tells you a little bit about where we are. And it says, I'm thinking we're Smithfield, right there. And we'll be traveling, if you want to get on the train, you can go all the way down to the stockyards, or all the way up to Dallas-Fort Worth Airport. Pretty cool. Here's the price. Single ride, one way. You got $250 and reduced. Looks like reduced
qualification for reduced is you have to be have a valid ID 65 years and older. And here are your passes, like local, one day, just to go running around for the day, 7 days monthly, and then annual. It's probably cheaper than, definitely cheaper than owning a car if this was convenient enough for you, so you could come over here to this train stop and hop on a train. This is where you would come and grab your tickets down below after you pay, or sign into the app. As I pan around here, looks like there's some, they have emergency call boxes. There's also another little map here, kind of tells you, I guess, where the train will be at specific times of day, and what train number to look for. This is really cool. I didn't even know this existed, and I've lived in this area for 20 years, maybe. I mean, I knew there were train tracks, but I didn't know it was like this well thought out. All right, so I'm now up on the platform. They've got trash cans. They've got little identifying markers, kind of telling you where you're at, track two. Yeah, kind of interesting. Stay away from the platform edge. I guess this being the platform. It's just a rubber mat so you don't slip. There's the train tracks. You've got this outdoor, looks like a seating area, almost like a bus stop. Then as you travel down a little further, you've got both sides with these individual booths. And I guess it tells you for some information, Smithfield Station, 819, track 2. And then places to cross over down there as well. Yeah, so straight shot, and I guess it just goes all the way to Dallas-Fort Worth Airport. Nice way to get downtown Fort Worth, which is probably 30 miles away from the airport. Very cool. You know, I'm so hungry. I could really go for a hamburger right now. Sorry, don't listen to this baby. Let's cover your eyes there. This is between you and me, Bubba. Okay, so one complaint so far that I've seen, the trail's amazing. Don't get me wrong. It's really cool. You got lots of things to do, lots of sights to see, really interesting vibe. Southwestern Texas, cows, trains, I mean, you name it. You've got everything over here. My helmet's pushing on my forehead here. You've got these crossways about every... It feels like I'm going almost every 500 yards, maybe 1,000 yards at the most, that there's a stop sign, and you got to stop for passing traffic. So, a little bit of a minor inconvenience, but all in all, really fun. But yeah, the stop signs are definitely gonna cause you to slow down your bike ride a little bit. Thank you.
So this is interesting. I just saw a sign that said end of bike trail, and I'm on the corner of Davis and the train tracks. But it looks like maybe, let's see, let me share this with you. It looks like maybe, so CottonBelt Trail, kind of where I began. I parked over here, rode to the trail. It continues to go on, but it says no bikes going that way. It's trying to take me up through here, through Little Bear Creek Park, where I was at the other day. So I don't want to go that way. It says here, you're here, total trail length, you're here. You're that way, but I want to continue on alongside the train tracks. Maybe it ends. Maybe it picks back up in Grapevine, or maybe this is the end. Okay, well, on that note, maybe it's time to go back. I'm torn. Do I want to go north? I really wanted to follow along the train tracks all the way to Grapevine. Bummer. What a letdown. Yeah, so I might drive up a little bit just to peek to see what's over there. Not necessarily a bike route, but maybe it's, maybe there's something there. Now, Davis is kind of a busy highway, so we shall see. But okay, anyways, okay, so we'll pick up back up here in a second. So here's the trail I came in on. Davis, and it's, there's a sign that it's a bike route, is that way. But as you can see, there's no like connector that crosses the road, and there's no trail that kind of travels alongside the train tracks. So yeah, maybe this is the end, but I'll go check it out.
It just gets longer every time I'm here.
For real. Isn't that neat? Pretty cool. My guess is this is an alpaca. Are you an alpaca? What are you? What are you? You're an interesting one. Whatever you are, you're fuzzy. You look like a stuffed teddy bear. They're probably stinky as can be. Maybe they spit. Who knows? But anyways, very neat. Kind of odd seeing these guys here in the middle of a sort of civilization kind of tucked away. This rare alpaca is a charming and valuable member of the camelid family. Alpacas are prized for their luxurious and costly fiber, which is harvested by shearing once a year. An alpaca sweater or blanket is a cherished possession, frequently handed down from one generation to the next. The alpaca gestation period is 11 months. The baby is called a cría. Alpacas are a herd animal and are native to the Andes Mountains of South America. Alpacas are very gentle, clean animals, and make wonderful pets. I bet you do. You look like a wonderful pet. Very cool. Look at a little sign there, alpaca crossing. There's Grapevine. Grapevine up ahead. This felt very apropos. You got the train tracks here. You've got a train coming there. There he goes. And over here, you got a little red caboose. And this one actually, in my last trains video, I had a, I showed you the one in Saginaw, Texas. This one is in Colleyville, Texas. And this one looks really, really done up nice. Even this guy here, which I'm guessing this would be pulled, this little wagon that would be pulled behind a horse drawn up and like a mini carriage. You know, obviously those aren't train rails or train tracks on it, but yeah, this is pretty cool. I love how they restored this. Very nice. Let me back up a little bit here so you can take in the magnitude of this thing. Yeah, it's a Burlington Northern Railway, BNSF, and there's your, I guess your serial number, 999729. You can see where it would couple into the next cart in front of it. My God, I guess they, I think they call it the knuckle. It's pretty solid. I mean, I guess this is the, for the hydraulic lines where they would hook up. And I guess this is where you could climb up here on the ladder or take the stairs. Not sure what this is for. That beeping was my GoPro saying battery just ran out. And if you look in, you can see there's a chair, a bench. Watch for slack action. That's what that says on that back door. Yeah, I guess you got a little nightlight there, where I guess whoever's at the back of the train here can keep an eye on things. Like a little stepway over there. I don't know if they call that the coop or whatever they call that, but that's pretty cool. And here's the other side of the train. Very nice. And there's my faithful steed down there. Let's see, I think there's a nice little seating area there. I wonder if that's like a bomb shelter or tornado shelter of some sort. Ah, so this little building was a post office. So here's your historical marker with respect to that post office. So let's look at this here. Bransford, a post office with the name Bransford opened in the vicinity in the late 19th century in 1889. So it's been here for a while. The post office was moved, to Red Rock on the route of the St. Louis, Arkansas and Texas Railroad, named for pioneer Felix Grundy Bransford. The post office name eventually replaced the name of Red Rock, and the town of Bransford became the center of a large farming community. Early residents of the area remembered a post office, two daily passenger trains, four doctors, two blacksmith shops, a livery stable, four general stores, and a lodge hall in the town. The railroad depot provided a passenger and supply center for the surrounding agricultural communities. The Bransford Lodge Hall, built in 1911, provided a meeting place for four groups: the Odd Fellows, Woodmen of the World, Knights of Modern Maccabees, and Farmers Union. It was also a gathering place for many community activities. The closing of the Bransford Post Office in 1913 and the advent of highway travel contributed to the decline of Bransford. By the time the city of Colleyville was incorporated in 1956, most reminders of the hamlet called Bransford had disappeared. Wow. See, I've lived here all this time. Did not know that this area was formerly known as Bransford. Ain't that something? I guess there you have it. There's the Bransford Post Office. Shut down in 1915, 106 years ago. So welcome to Bransford, Colleyville. There's the Colleyville Tower. And you've got some really interesting little wind figurines that are spinning here. Windmills, maybe? Wind chimes, but they don't chime. Wind spinners. Very cool. They are friendly. Friendly. Hi, guys. Hey, friendly. Hey there. Well, hello. There are two of yous. Well, hello, you. Hi, handsome. You're like a big teddy bear. I love you. These guys are great. Isn't that the sweetest fate? Albert, where are you going, Albert? Albert the alpaca. He came right up to me and just stared at me for about 2 minutes. You're amazing. You're an amazing alpaca. You are so cute. Look at you.
5 hours later.
All right, so the biking adventure is over. I'm all done and I'm back home. I'm actually out going to pick up my daughter from work, but just some general thoughts about the bike adventure today. First off, the starting spot really can be either in Grapevine or in North Richland Hills. So the key thing is when you go out, just remember you gotta turn around and go back. The ride that I took from the beginning, parked at the Sam's parking lot, going all the way down to the other Sam's parking lot in Grapevine, was around, I'm thinking, maybe 11 miles, 12 miles. There's a spot I didn't record mileage, but I did. It said I did like 21 miles, but there was like a 2 mile stretch I didn't record. So I'm thinking it was right around 23 miles round trip from Sam's to Sam's. If I would have gone up a little bit further, went up to the train station in Grapevine, which is really kind of like an old, which was an old fashioned kind of train station. That one is maybe another 2 or 3 miles more to get to that. But all in all, it was fun. It was a fun ride. I really enjoyed getting out there, and it was cold. It was cold. So it was 40, probably 46 degrees when I started driving Fahrenheit.
And by the time I finished, it was about 50, 51. I was able to get back. I brought the bike home, put it on the charger. It's been on the charger for about 3 or 4 hours now. It's 2:20 p.m. and I hooked it up on the charger probably around 11-ish p.m. or a.m. excuse me, 11 in the morning. But yeah, I ended up getting back. And when I hooked it up on the charger, it said it was in the green level, which was the medium level. So yeah, not sure about the gauge. I'm kind of 50-50 on that, but it's rated at 30 to 50 miles and I only went about probably like 23, 24. So all in all, I had a really fun trip. I enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed the video today. I do appreciate you taking the time to stop, let's tune in and watch the video. Hopefully today's video gave you some inspiration to get out there, and whether it be bike riding, whether it be walking, or just seeing what's around in your area. There were so many things I didn't know that are in my local area here in Fort Worth, Texas, which is just flat country, just flat area, that I was just impressed by. I was very impressed about the history and the culture that was here in the area. And Texas is a newer state. So you've got states up in the Northeast that's got hundreds of years of history, several hundreds. Whereas here in my area, it's only, what is it? 1800s, you know, as far as modern history and having modern buildings and things like that are around. But regardless, I'm watching a train. There's a car that's gonna pull some train cars and nobody's stopping for him and he's just beeping at him. So poor guy. but regardless, but anyways, it was fun. It was a great trip. It was neat seeing all the trains and all the path that went around the trail. The spot in the middle where I found out that the trail ended, it actually didn't end. It was just the sign was misleading. It just said the bike lane ends. However, it didn't really kind of guide you, telling you where does the bike lane continue or how to continue on the bike lane or how to continue on the same path that you're on. So that was a little misleading. It wasn't very clear on how to continue and maintain on the path. But all in all, it was really fun. So I had a blast, burned a lot of calories. I did do quite a bit of pedaling. The bike did assist several times throughout the ride, but I did probably maybe, I would say, one third of the work, maybe closer to half the work, whereas on previous rides I was doing like a third or a quarter of the work. So I'm getting better. I'm getting a little stronger where I can actually go a little farther. I've got a new seat cushion or cover, like a gel cover, so my butt's not as sore, which is a good thing. Yay, insert applause sound. Yay. So I feel great and I can't wait for my next adventure. It's only a shame that next week, towards the end of the week, it's supposed to drop down into the teens and highs in the low 30s. So can't really get out in that weather, or at least I'm not used to those type of temperatures here in North Texas. So yeah, with that being said, I appreciate you tuning in. Be sure to like, thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to let others know if they're interested in fun adventures, to share the channel with them. And yeah, thanks for tuning in. I've left some product links down in the description if you're interested in some of the gear that I have. I've started doing that, so you could, if you're interested in looking at the GoPro or the DJI Mavic drone, or the Espin bike. I've got links to all of those down in the description. So if you're interested in any of that gear, click on the links and take a look at it and see if it interests you. I'll always do your own research and do your own studies, but that's about it. So this is Adventuring Art signing out for today, and we will see you on the next adventure. Later. Thank you.